Righto, so I'm exhausted. I've been through five different countries in the last 3 days, sorting things out for this next stage of our ride. About 6 months ago, I offered anyone that wanted to join us the chance to come and do Hannibal's Crossing with us. General Hannibal led his Carthaginian army, which had elephants and about 9,000 cavalry, over the Alps about 2,500 years ago to take the fight to Rome. And he did it in winter. So we're doing it in summer, which should be a bit easier, but it'll be hot. And just like him going into it, there were a lot of unknowns. So we've got a lot of unknowns as well. We've had to organize new horses for the American ladies that are joining us. We just wanted people to bring their own horses. And now we're organizing horses, we're organizing horse transports. It's insane. Lou and I are working our asses off, and it's been a real lesson to us that as long riders that you need to just deal with your own shit and no one else's. It's complicated enough as it is. So I'm back in Germany. I'm building saddlebags for people. I'm building tethers. I've just built another saddle that's to fit one of the horses that's going. There's no real time for testing. And as I said, there's a lot of red flags. This ride could be a very public and spectacular failure. But if it's not, and we hope it's not, it's going to be testament to the lessons we've learned from all of those failures we've had. And we have had endless failures. Biggest failure we've always had is taking other people's word, trusting people, and doing things for others. When we just look after ourselves, it goes a lot better. But we have to keep trying new things. We have to keep offering others the chance to live their dreams as well. We don't want to sit in an ivory tower and shit on other people. Not that we'd ever be able to build an ivory tower with. We're still just a dreamer and a drunk. Very tired drunk. I might go have a wine, build some saddlebags. So this is Hannibal's Crossing. This is where it starts. Exhausted in a basement in Memmingham, having left my wife on the French roadside, crying her eyes out with a crazy horse and a little dog with a sore paw. Nice. Reality for you. It's not as cool as you think. It's not as pretty. It's not as romantic. It's not a magical honeymoon. It's hard fucking work. So I'm away to Hungary, then Transylvania, then Romania. Pile of saddles there. Made it to Munich. On the way.
We were so bright. Standing in the sunlight, never got burned. We were alright, had that easy kind of love, and I let it in. For a moment.
Felt
like we were floating. Maybe I swear we were golden. It was easy, natural as breathing air. And when the sky went dark, you think I would've known before we let it get this far. I should've let you go. Now I gotta crawl. Look at us now, hard as I try, I get halfway up the wall and you pull me down.
And when the sky went dark, you think I would've known before we let it get this far. I should've let you go. Now I gotta call.
Marengo, you're just such a Marengo. There you go, boys. The bromance begins. So, I hope this video would have ended with us tearing off. You're all right, buddy. Tearing off up through the Alps, but instead we're still here in this absolutely incredible place in France. These people are just the most beautiful people ever. They've really turned my opinion of France around. The cuisine's been exceptional. The boy is just, he is everything we hoped he would be and more. Jilly is still a Jilly. And Marengo is still a Marengo. Oh, here comes Jilly's little friend. That's the little dog that was just rescued last night. And all's well that ends well. And that woman there is not only beautiful, but one of the finest instructors I have ever seen in my life. What do you have to say about the kids here, Lou?
They're so awesome. They're just running around helping, sweeping the ground.
The standard of horsemanship that we've seen here, in my opinion, is the highest I've seen throughout our journey. It's as good as the very best. I love it here. They're good people. Let's walk up the hill to the French restaurant for a trout, Jilly.